Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, collectors of all ages, it is Aussieverse, and we are back tonight with What We Read June of 2024. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We really hope you like the video, and whether you do or you don't, still press that like button because it really helps us out, and it's a small favor that we ask for you. Now, tonight is What We Read. I've already said that, I know, but I'm always trying to come up with these intros and I have all this stuff in my head. And then as soon as I press record, I forget it all. So I've just forgotten it all. So let's move on. Single issue, Steve, A Big Mac and Sharif. How are you guys?
Pumped.
Yeah, we're good.
Always, always good to see you, fellas.
Fantastic. If you would like any sort of critiquing, if you would like any sort of comments, if you have any ideas for shows, or if you just want to come on, hit us up at Instagram_Aussieverse. You can also check us out at TikTok at Aussieverse. You can also see Facebook at Aussieverse for life. Don't forget Sanation Comics right here on Instagram. And you can also don't forget we are I'm really not on top form tonight. Our graphic designer and decides, guys, I've got a bat problem at home. I have not had good night's sleep for about 2 or 3 months because every single night I have all night outside my window.
And a bat problem.
An actual bat problem. Oh, and I keep assuming that they're just going to go away because it's never happened before. And, you know, I don't want to, like, do anything to the bats. I don't know what I would do to the bats. But all night they wake me up. So I put on my my sleep thing on my phone, you know, the waves and the whoosh and all that, and I play that really loud to drown out the bats. But then at 3 a.m. I'm getting woken up. And I'm not kidding. I can't go back to bed. And I'm really suffering at work. I don't know what to do. I had an idea. I went to the council. Council said, sorry, we can't do anything because they're protected bats. And I said, okay, well, what do I do now? And they're like, you can click this one and see what they do. And I'm like, look, I'm not asking you to kill the bats. I'm just asking you to maybe contact my neighbor where the bat's tree is and say to them, can you trim your tree down or something? Or I don't know what, mate, but I now hate bats. I need sleep.
I had the same problem with my neighbor. My neighbor had a guava tree.
Your neighbor's a bat?
Big one.
Man, the tree is just outside my window behind the fence. So what I did was I went on Temu, I bought a flamethrower and done.
I went on Temu and
was that real?
No.
I was going to go to Temu.
If you guys have a bat problem, I know a guy. He's really good. He's from Wuhan. He can get the job done. He'll take care of your bats.
Really?
Yeah, we're not going to go there anymore.
We've been there once. We ended up in lockdown.
I am so tired. I am gullible on everything right now.
You were like, is he good? Can you link me his contact, please? What's the video about? What's the video about?
Let's get back. We also hope people without glasses aren't watching tonight. This is not a glasses club, but we really hope people with glasses are watching. Okay, it is. Glasses, yeah, because we're all a little nerdy here. All right, let's get on with the freaking video. Okay, we're going to roll the dice. Pick a number. I'm going to see who goes first.
Seven.
Six.
Is it a
7?
19.
No, you all suck so hard.
It's a D20, isn't it?
Oh, you know what? Fine. We're going to go with, let's see here. Do, 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 do. No, that's the wrong button. This one.
Oh.
This one. Oi, oh. You're on, mate.
Oh. Out of there. Was that the randomizer? What's going on? I'm sorry. I'm being very distracted. Are we starting with me?
No. You're just... No, you know what? We're going to start with Sharif, but you just stay right there.
All right. All I've got are single issues because I've got issues, but no longer single, which is a good segue. These are two things that I picked up that I've read recently. This is a university magazine, which it's got a couple of cool poems, but look at that great ass cover art.
And that's good. I like that.
And this one, which I've been told I got from my missus, so just putting it out there now.
Oh, you got a misso.
Hard launch. No Man's Land. This was pretty awesome to check out. It's got some cool styles. It's like a coming of age story. I got to the end, and I even send a very direct message to the creator saying, when's issue 2? Need to get my hands on issue 2. Still no word. So for the creator out there.
Where can people grab that? Because I actually want to know for myself.
So you can get this from the comic store, or as of very recently, if you head down to All Star Comics, you can get the full US comic size edition.
Oh, sweet.
All Star Comics now in Melbourne. So other than that, if you're in Adelaide, you can hit up the creator herself, Shaden Du, and get this. And do me a favor and request a new printing of issue 2, because the good people out there got to know.
I've got to admit, you know, with all these Aussie creators, Shaden's I always skipped past because I didn't know her. And now that I do know her, I just really want to read what comes out of that head, because she's an amazing person. So
yes,
we've got to get that.
And that head is insane. Okay. Next up, we got a couple of picks. We're moving on, gentlemen. We're moving on. I hope she doesn't see this, but she's probably.
Oh, I'm making sure she watches this now.
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to pay for it.
Something epic. Moving on.
Something epic and Blood Commandment. These were These are two titles I really wanted to pick up. Simon Kudransky, I was a big fan of his from Spawn. And then when I heard he started doing his own thing under the title One Man Art, One Man Art. I had to check it out. This was cool. It's like vampires, but there's a twist. I think he's a good writer. He's got a good command of the English language, and I'm pretty sure English is his second language. But this, something epic, really, really freaking good.
Oh, really? Because I've been seeing those covers, and I've been really wanting to read it myself.
Yeah, I would highly recommend it. You would enjoy the collected edition. I am an addict, so I like to grab every single issue, and I don't care if I read it at a snail's pace. I must have them all. But no, really, really good. It's imaginative, but it's also got some, you know, high stakes and stuff that you can really get involved with. So I'm like, highly recommend Something Epic, Simon Kudransky. Pick this bad boy up from the $2 bin, because I was like, everybody talks about Saga. Let's go dip our toe in it. And I was very fortunate that chapter 43 kind of began a new arc. So I was able to kind of have a lot of stuff explained to me. I really like the way Brian K. Vaughan writes. It's a cool, it's a very organic, relatable sort of way that you're brought into this fantastical world. And I've heard that they're back from their hiatus. So lots of good news.
If you're interested, I know it'll take you 15 years to read it, but I've got the first three hardcovers. So if you do want to borrow them and just read it, next time you're over, take them.
You're gonna notice a hole in your bookcase.
I notice a hole a lot, and I'm used to it. It's fine.
nobody wants to hear about your hole. What?
It's under your first read by Brian K. Vaughan, or have you read other stuff from him as well?
No, this is my first Brian K. Vaughan read. Yeah, just the one.
Another one you recommend off the top of your head, Sharif?
Why the Last Man?
Oh yeah, of course. Hell yes.
Okay. I like these. People recommendations, because people are nice. I had to pick this one up. Zoe Thorogood, Hackslash, because I've seen a lot of her stuff, and I was like, yeah, it looks cool. She got dicks on her face, and the dog drew the dicks, so it's pretty cool. I like her art style. I like, you know, she still strikes me as a little bit of like this young writer, but there's definitely the promise to see her. I want to read It's Lonely at the Center of the Earth, which is her own thing. So I just want to see that to see what all the fuss is about. But I can see why she's big. Like she's doing very well for herself. Pick this bad boy up, Tenement, Jeff Lemire. I did it because I've been seeing Jeff Lemire's name floating around a lot of horror stuff. And I was like, you know what? Let's dip our toe in it. Wow. Really, really freaking good first issue to, you know, set up stakes. And it's like, it's been a while since I read I wondered, like, is horror kind of dead in books? And this was a really good, just, you know, suspense, questions. And you get to the end and you're just like, I've been edged this whole time and you don't really get the finish, but you know, you want more. So I'm definitely going back for subsequent reviews. Here's a real crazy what I read. I picked this one up because this was going for like real cheap, like $3-$4, like the US price. And I was like, that's insane. I know this is the first appearance of Lobo and it's a steal. It's going for like $3-$4. And then I saw there was quite a few of them. So I was like,
your internet maybe he's is an just not piece
popular or whatever.
Your internet is an absolute piece of shit.
Am I lagging?
No, you're not lagging. It's just like, you know.
How laggy am I?
I feel like that's I'm going blind watching you.
Okay, maybe I'll just hold this up nice and still. yeah, so it turns out I didn't get a good buy. This was a freaking like second, third. It's a facsimile.
So oh.
I'm an idiot. I bought that, I read it, and I'm like, man, the 80s was whack. This also a facsimile. But I'm a big fan. I like that cover. I love the Frank Miller run. So I was like, yeah, you know what, worth it. Good get. And as crazy as this may sound, when you finally do it, when you spend so much time doing a book, it's very hard to get the time to read it. So part of my recent reads list is the book that we made because I finally had time to actually sit down amidst the promoting and everything. I'm really glad that we've gotten this far to be able to put this thing out. And it is now in All Star Comics. So if you're in Melbourne, go to All Star Comics and you can grab this bad boy.
What a twist. Even if you're not. Whoa.
Oh, even if you're not in Melbourne. Sorry, go.
You, Sharif.
Could go online, get it from the online shop.
Or get it from us. We've got them. We've got a whole bunch of them.
I was going to say, what a twist would it have been if you're like, I finally read it and I hated it.
I read it. I wrote a very angry letter to the creators. I sent poop through his mail. But no, it's quite a nice feeling to be able to kind of like, after all this time that you get all wrapped up in it, that you can sit back and just like, just read it for what it is. No pressure. And yeah man, I'm excited. I want to bring issue 2 soon. Cause I'm going, when is issue 2 coming out? And I'm like, I want to bring it soon. We just need that you know, all the good people to get behind it. But I'm very excited. I'm excited to do it and to then read it.
Sweet. Is that it?
That's it. That's all I got. All single issues, baby. Just this nice hot. Yeah.
That's a good stack, man. It's a good stack. Yeah. So most of mine are digital. The reason being, if you did watch last month's, is because I decided to go back and read the last 4 years of X-Men, which is the Krakoa age. And there are so many titles in that. It is just insane. In saying that, it's been a month and a half, and I am now up to The Fall of X, which is the last chunk of it up until now. So I'm nearly there, man. I'm nearly there. I've been reading it like freaking crazy, as well as my normal monthlies that I won't talk about, like Spider-Man, Venom, things like that. So it's a lot of reading. So X-Men went
What did you think of it, though, mate? Did you like it?
Well, dude, the standout parts to me overall is I'm really shocked where they've taken Beast, the character. I don't know how Beast is ever going to come back from the status quo that he's in now. I just don't get it. Like he's not evil, but he's certainly not good. You know, he's almost like Nick Fury. You know, and he's just like I don't want to say too much with spoiling it, but there are things Beast has done that he just can't come back from. And as a reader, you're like, dude, I want to forgive that, but that was just cold. That was callous, you know. And yeah, man, I just don't know. You know, there's a few stupid things in there along the way, like Forge building Wolverine an adamantium surfboard so Wolverine can surf, which doesn't make any sense because, you know, they try and explain how he wouldn't just sink, but, you know, I don't care what you're saying. In all the years of Red Wolverine, I don't think he's once brought up the fact that he wants to surf. Storm is by far now, if it's not Cyclops, Storm is definitely the leader of the X-Men. She is progressed so far above where she started all those years ago. She is a real hell of a leader. Professor X, I just don't like. I said it last month when I was talking about it. It just doesn't read like Professor X to me at all. And I kept waiting for the swerve of it really not being Professor X the whole time, but apparently it is. And I just don't like him. I don't get this Krakoan age of Professor X. I don't like him at all. What else? Look, I have been enjoying it. There has been a lot of like, even though Hickman hasn't written it all, there's been a lot of Hickman-esque sort of things that I kind of feel a bit stupid in, not really soaking it in with the different sorts of characters, that a bunch of new characters and things that happen. But I just read it sort of quickly and try to persevere through. So going back to the actual titles, first off is The X-Men by Jerry Duggan. That's pretty cool. I don't mind that. I've been reading it. I've been enjoying it. Next is Hellions, which I have really been enjoying. There's a couple of characters in there, like that egg there and that Iron Man-looking fella that I'd never heard of before, and a few other characters. And I've really grown to really enjoy this team. There's some characters that I really, really dig, and I highly recommend Hellions. Wolverine, I've really been liking. A lot of people, from what I've heard, haven't been really liking it, but I have. I think it's been pretty cool. There's a few crossovers, like with Ghost Rider. There's the Sabretooth War. There's a few other things. But, yeah, I've really been digging Wolverine. One that I didn't think I would like because I've actually never read this character before, even though I've got an omnibus of him, is Cable. And I read Young Cable, and that was actually really cool. I dug it, and it made me really like him. And now, I'm looking forward to reading more Cable. They then had some one-shots. They had giant-size X-Men, for example, Magneto, giant-size X-Men Storm. They then had giant-size X-Men Phantom X, giant-size X-Men Nightcrawler, and giant-size X-Men Jean Grey and Emma Frost. And all of those are like a big one-shot on them. None of them really matter too much in the big scheme of things, except for Magneto's. Magneto's has a bit to do with it, but all of those one-shots are really cool. Moving on, we've got X-Factor. This one I'm really looking forward to because Daken, Wolverine's son, up at the top there, is a character that I always loved, who is now a reformed supervillain. He's quite different. He's quite differently written now because he's quite nice, but he's good. This character with the eyes that you see, that's Eye Boy. I'd never seen him. Yeah.
Eye Boy.
Yeah. He's actually...
Reminds me very much a strong guy.
Yeah.
That used to be the X-Factor.
But he's actually got really cool powers because with every eye... he can see something different, whether it be X-ray vision, telescopic vision, and so forth. And it goes so far as to say, like, he can even read body language and micro expressions, and there's basically nothing that he can't see. And it's just quite incredible. It's actually quite an incredible power. And because he's a young kid as well, you actually start to really like that character, I think. And I've got to be honest, I kind of want to see more Eye Boy. He was a good character. We then have Juggernaut. Speaking of reformed villains, I don't remember Juggernaut becoming good, but he is now. In fact, he's now a full
cool fledged cover.
Yeah, it was a 5-issue miniseries. And it wasn't bad. You know, you could skip it if you just read in the Krakoan Age. But yeah, Juggernaut's a full fledged good guy now, and he's part of the X-Men. Way of X. It was all right. I didn't mind it. It's about Nightcrawler to basically trying to create some sort of like mutant religion. Not really, but yes. It was all right. I liked the premise of it, but yeah, you know, I'd probably skip that one too, to be honest. Next is the X-Force team. X-Force is fantastic. X-Force, a lot of it runs side by side with Wolverine, and this is where you see a lot of the stuff that Bullseye does. Beast. A lot of the stuff that Beast does. Some horrible things happen to Domino and Kid Omega. Colossus is a bit of a sad story in this one. But yeah, I do recommend X-Force. I really think it's really cool. Next we have X-Corp, which is a corporation that Angel and a couple of other people start, which is really just the corporate side of the X-Men. I didn't really dig that too much, but it didn't last for that long either. Next is Marauders. The Marauders, the first run, I really, really loved. I really thought it was great. It's about a boat that is run by Kitty Pryde with certain people on it, and they go and rescue. Hey?
Catherine. She hates being called Kitty now.
Yeah. Captain Kate, I think it is now. And the first run was really good. It got restarted to a number one again, and I haven't really dug this version of the Marauders. It's all about being in space and stuff, and I'm not really digging it. Next is Children of the Atom. That was all right. It was only a 5-issue miniseries. It was about kids that are pretending to be mutants, but really weird, stupid names like Nighty Nightcrawler and things like that. Yeah, you know. I think I've bored everybody because no one's here except you, Sharif. Oh, he's back. Next we have Trial of Magneto. This is a little bit of a letdown because I was expecting a lot more from this. Why is Magneto on trial? You'll have to see the second Hellfire Gala. But it was all right. It was all right. They really should have called it something like the resurrection of Scarlet Witch into the X-Men, you know, because it was more about that than Magneto.
Question for you, mate.
Yep.
Is Archangel, because I haven't read Marvel stuff for a long time, is Archangel as a character still around, or is that...
So
he's Angel, one of my favorites.
He's Angel, but he's like the Hulk, and he can transform into Archangel at will.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, I think that's weird too.
I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Because his whole story of, you know, what Apocalypse did to him and how he tormented him and all that sort of stuff is a major part of who he is as a character. So that's really bizarre that they've done that with him.
Yeah, that's right. I agree. Next, we've got Excalibur, which on paper, this is something that I should love. It's about King Arthur, Merlin, and mutants, and I just don't dig it. I just don't, and I really wanted to, but I just couldn't get into it, man. I skipped quite a bit of it, to be honest. Just flipped through, you know. New Mutants is really cool. I ended up liking, because I'd never read New Mutants before, I ended up loving every single one of these characters. So if you've never read New Mutants before, you can just jump on here. Each character is really a home run as far as writing is concerned, I think.
Do you know one thing that I don't like about a lot of the images and stuff that you're showing is the massive chunk of colour at the top with the title of the book in it. It takes up like a third of the page. It looks shit.
Yeah, that was all the Krakoan Age. If you look at the spines of them all, they're all colour-coded like that as well.
Yeah, it's just too big. A little bit smaller would be all right, but yeah, too big. Yeah. That's just me being picky.
No, well, I don't blame you. That's a fair enough point. The next one is Sword.
Agreed. A second.
Aaron, what was that?
Oh, no, a second, Steve's. Yeah, I'm like, yeah. Too much.
Sword has been pretty good. That only went for about 80 issues or so. Abigail Brand is a complete B-I-T-C-H, but in a good way. A little bit Nick Fury-ish as well. So now that I said that about Beast, Beast is a whole nother level. Surprisingly enough, I got told that I need to read X-Men Unlimited, which is a digital only on the Marvel app, because there's a few things that happen in there. And I didn't want to because there's so many titles, but I'm so grateful that I did read what they dubbed as the X-Men Green, which was the second arc in X-Men Unlimited. You can skip the first arc of X-Men Unlimited. It was pretty stupid Wolverine story. That doesn't really matter. But the second one is really, really cool. Wolverine Green is this character, this woman with the horns. Her mutant power is that she's connected to nature. And she's always just been this little kid that was in the backstory, never really that important to the X-Men. She all of a sudden feels the earth and what mutants and what humans have done to the earth. And she goes fully a romper stomper on the world. She ends up like shaving her head and killing people and leaving Krakoa and just decides like, if you're not for the earth, then you can just go get effed. And she just goes really, really evil, but evil for a good reason. Next is X Lives and X Deaths of Wolverine. That was okay. Wasn't bad. I'm still very confused, and people please tell me in the comments if you're into the Krakoan Age. I'm still very confused as to why Moira has gone bad. I just don't get it. I'm sure it was explained, but I just don't get it. Also, Steve, you asked what did I think of the Krakoan Age. A couple of things that really stick out for me that I don't understand or like is that one of the rules that they came up with the island is they wouldn't allow any precogs on the island, no mutants with precognitive abilities. And that was because Moira was afraid of everybody seeing the future that she wanted to hide. I get that. But how can you honestly say that you're going to have a place for mutant kind where everybody can be there, including all the villains, but yet you're not going to allow the precogs? Like, that just sounds so, like, against what they're doing. Like, it just doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever, and I don't know how they've explained that at all. But Moira, why is she evil now, guys? I just don't get it. Next is Legion of X, which is Charles Xavier's son, Legion. He is also a reformed villain. Not bad. I'm not a fan of comics that are like in the dreamscape and things like that because I'm too literal with the way that I read my books. And when things are like wavy and things aren't very clear to me, I'm like, I get a little lost in how, you know, I read it and I don't really get excited about it anymore. X-Men,
no, Doctor Strange.
That's a bit different. Like, yeah, okay, so if an example, one example is like Silver Surfer Black. Everybody loved Silver Surfer Black. And to me, that was just a whole bunch of colors everywhere. And I'm like, I don't really know what's going on because it's just art everywhere, you know. Like somebody, it's like a clown vomited on the pages, and people go, "Ooh, that is so cool," and it might be, but where is this character walking? I don't get it. X-Men Red is really cool. This is about them taking over the planet of Mars and terraforming it and making a home for a certain bunch of mutants, which doesn't sit right with the human population. Storm is the on the council of Arako, which is what they rename Mars. If you're going to read any two X-Men titles that are really important to X-Men Krakoa Age, I would recommend X-Men Red, and the next one being Immortal X-Men by Kieran Gillen. This one is where all the council, the Quiet Council they're called, do all their planning and talking and yada, yada, yada. There's not really much I can say about that without giving stuff away, but Immortal X-Men is very, very good to read. Next is Knights of X. This is a continuation of Excalibur. I was bored to tears with it, so I read like one or two issues and then I just skipped the rest and made sure I didn't miss anything really important. Next was Exterminators. Now, this I really, really enjoyed. I think it's because the X-Men are always so serious and I'm reading such serious stuff so often that the Exterminators was a nice palette change, because this is Jubilee, Dazzler, Boom Boom, and Lauren Wolverine all go out to get drunk because Dazzler has broken up with her boyfriend. And like, it was just a fun story. It went for like five issues and it was about these girls just going out, wanting to go get drunk. Obviously something happens, they fight the something, and then they go back out, and it ends with like Wolverine grabbing beers and going, "Are you ready, sluts?" You know, which I was very surprised to read. It was cool. Next is Bishop War College. This is a five-issue miniseries about Bishop training young up-and-coming X-Men. What surprised me about it is that in the story, they get transported to a world where every X-Men character is black. I forgot to get the image, but Black Beast looks amazing because he's like got these blue massive dreadlocks, and you know, there's a Wolverine that's black, there's a Cyclops that's black, everybody's black, you know. And you know, it was actually pretty funny. It was great.
Is Bishop just Bishop?
Yeah, so Bishop actually meets himself, and Bishop is like this bookworm that's never been in a fight before. And he's like, you're a mutant, damn you. And he's like, no, I teach the kids, you know. And yeah, it was good. He's like, you're a mutant, god damn it, you know. Next is New Mutants Lethal Legion. Again, this was a continuation from New Mutants. This was a miniseries. Very, very good. Really, really liked it. Love all the characters in New Mutants. I want to go back now and read more New Mutants. Rogue and Gambit. I'm sure there's been heaps of Rogue and Gambit miniseries. This one was another good one. I'll just leave it at that one. This is what I'm currently up to. They did about four or five one-shots called Before the Fall. This image, as you can see, is Before the Fall, the Heralds of Apocalypse. And it's a one-shot about Apocalypse. They then had a one-shot like Sons of Sinister and a couple of other ones. And it's basically these four stories that start before the fall of X, which is what I'm currently up to. The last two things that I'm going to talk about is Spider-Man Shadow of the Green Goblin. I read this just yesterday, and this is set in the time just before Norman Osborn becomes the Green Goblin, and they introduce a character that has always existed but has now been retconned into being always there, and that is the Proto-Goblin. And the Proto-Goblin is a person that Norman Osborn injected with the initial Goblin serum to test it on him, and he turned into this red creature sort of thing. and we never even heard of him before. So I'm guessing this one shot that shows you him is going to have an effect in the future of Spider-Man. I did forget to mention as well, in Marauders, they brought back a character, guys, that I cannot freaking believe. It blew me the hell away. So you all know how much I love the Clone Saga, right? Spider-Man, the Clone Saga, that is. They've pretty much brought back all the main characters from that in the last 20 years at some point. Scarlet Spider, Kane, Scarlet Spider's girlfriend, whoever else, right? But there is one character that got invented for the Clone Saga that has only ever been in the Clone Saga, and nobody has seen him for like 20 plus years. And out of all of the characters they bring back in the X-Men, it's this one, and his name is Judas Traveler. Now, Judas Traveler had like godlike powers where he could pretty much do anything, and the writers got rid of him because they pretty much wrote him into a corner where they've overpowered him, and they didn't really know what to do with him ever since. And now all of a sudden he's working for Orcus. Orcus is the team that is trying to kill all the X-Men, and it's mind-blowing because for people like me, yeah, it's great. But for young audiences, I don't know why they'd make that decision, especially in X-Men, because they're not going to know who this guy is. They're not going to – like, such a weird choice to bring back a character from Spider-Man into X-Men and from the Clone Saga. Like, wow, I just can't believe it. But I'm so excited to see him again because it's like – my childhood coming back, you know? So anyway, last but not least, sorry, is I wanted to spice it up a little with not just reading X-Men all the time. So I finally pulled out my bone and I started reading it. And grow up, guys. And have any of you read Bone?
Not yours, no.
Okay.
No.
So,
I've seen yours now.
Everybody and their mother says this is brilliant. Everybody. When you ask reviewers about what books should be in every library, what comic should everybody read, they say titles like Mouse and Watchmen and things like that. Bone is always in that conversation. So I have always wanted to read it. What's always thrown me off about it, and I've never understood how it could be so loved and well received, is when you look at the art of it, right? It looks like something that you would see in your newspapers, right? Like a Garfield sort of thing. And I read the first few pages a long time ago, and I went, oh yeah, it's got a bit of humor. I'll get back to that one day. Now, I am that far into it, and boy, this stuff is like Lord of the Rings level. It is not what you expect whatsoever. It is so well written. It is so great in world building. It is so funny but so serious. It is absolutely freaking amazing. So whenever I want to read at home now and stop from X-Men, I'm just continuing Bone. It comes in a color edition now as well, not just black and white. Black and white was the original. And if you want to get a much better review of Bone, then go Google, YouTube it. And there are many, many videos about why this is such a good book. And I highly, highly recommend you go get it. I think you can get the whole thing for like $50. It is really, really good, guys. And I haven't even finished it yet, you know? And that's it.
Well done, mate. Oh, my turn. All right. I've only got a few because I've been pretty busy with life and kids and stuff. So, all right. So some of these I've touched on briefly, but I'll go through them again to finish reading them. Firstly, DC versus Vampires, Volume 2. This is a lot of fun. I really enjoy this series. And some of the additional artwork, for instance, that is just stunning.
Yeah.
Absolutely love that. Really good story. The Vampire King, I'm not going to spoil it. It's not someone that you would have expected. Really, really good read. Really, really enjoyed that.
Do you know, I doubt it's something you'd buy, but it's something that I wanted to buy but didn't because I know it would just be on the shelf. They have a DC versus Vampires, like a Treasury Edition portfolio art book of just all the covers and stuff.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's like the size of like the Art Germ ones that I've got. Like it's big. So if you really love them, and you may be even able to pull them out safely. Like they may have built it that way so you can frame them too.
Yeah, that's cool. Mm. Yeah, awesome. I'll keep an eye out for that, mate. Thank you for telling me. I didn't know. I'm about halfway through this, written by Australia's own Tom Taylor, which is brilliant. This is my latest in my Sunday Reads with Single Issue, Steve. I normally put up every week. I'm having a coffee on a Sunday morning. This is really good. I'm really, really enjoying this. And I haven't actually read any Nightwing before. So this is my first entry into Nightwing. I'm really glad I picked this up. I really am. And I can't wait to get to the next one as well. I started reading this last time, but I have finished it. And again, haven't read much Flash. This was great. I really enjoyed this, especially the story. And I touched on it briefly in a previous video, but the one where Captain Cold just wants to go and buy some beer and they think he's trying to rob the store and all he wants to do is buy a beer so he can go back and watch the ice hockey. But it was a great little story in that. So that's a good read too. What else have I got here? Read this one, first one in the series. Again, I don't read a lot of Wonder Woman stuff. This is surprising. I'm really looking forward to the next issues. I've got another four of these to read. So I think there's five in the whole series. This is a great story too. So I haven't picked up anything shit so far, so I'm really happy. And the last couple of things I've got are, where are we? There we go. So another great Aussie artist and all-round lovely guy, Brad Daniels. This is my first thing. I love this thing. This thing is really funny. It's just such a great concept, grabbing old books and completely retelling the stories by rewording them. Brad, you're a bloody genius, mate. This thing is a lot of fun. And again, thank you for signing it. Oh, over here for me too. When we were at Comic-Con, it was really nice to meet you, mate. So I look forward to picking up some more of those. And I've got one of these already as a foil cover, but I've got another one as well. And I thought, I wonder if it's any better than the first one. It wasn't, which is disappointing, but it was just as good as the first one. I love these, Azza. Well done, mate. Good read, good read. Oh, do you know what? I forgot to check the card. I was doing unveiling while we're here.
Yeah, that's right. So to date, the only two people who have been able to figure out the mystery with help is Ben Sullivan and that guy up there in the top square.
Yeah.
Although when we
Jason help, Lee card.
I declined that positive line that you just gave me, thank you very much, because that is not true. I basically got pointed out.
Sorry.
And even then I still like miss said a lot,
All right, the only two people
that's my reading.
Yeah.
Sorry, as you go, mate. Solid. The only two people that know
the riddle. I mean, the answer to it.
Yes, Steve. So let's see how smart you are.
Oh, well, that's me out already.
We're going to sit here and wait for you to come up with the answer. Nobody talk. Shush.
We're going to be here for a while.
I hope you guys have packed your lunch for tomorrow. Seriously, I struggle to solve one side of a Rubik's Cube. Let's move on to Sharif. What have you got, Sharif? What have you read this month?
Good man. Honestly, not much on my end. I've been catching up on a lot of TV series. I just finished Ted, the nine. I almost said nine episode series. up to date with The Boys, and I'm just about to start season 2 of my adventures with Superman. Looking forward to that. However, I did get through at least one book, and it is okay. So, disclaimer: with all the books that I've gotten, the ones that I've read from the library, from the Brisbane Library, not nice. My own library. One of it is Volume 1 of Dark Knights of Steel. I've been waiting.
Please tell me it's bad.
I can't say that, because I keep telling myself, okay, I'm gonna wait for the deluxe that collects all 12, and then I saw this on the shelf in the library and thought, well, okay, let's try it out. So Volume 1 collects the first 6 issues. It does read like the old Elseworlds stories, so it's set in the medieval times. Tells the story of the L family. That's right, family, not just one L. And it sets in the kingdom, and then you get introduced with all the other recognizable characters, the Robins. You still have Bruce as the Batman, and the character designs aren't too far off from those that we already know. So they are recognizable even if the names aren't introduced yet. But I am looking forward to Volume 2, which I don't think I want to pick up. I want the whole thing all over again. So if not read this, and if you are one of the old people who remember what Elseworlds is, pick this up.
So I said I'm hoping it's bad, because I bought the first 2 hardcovers, never opened them, and just recently sold them. It's for reasons. And now there's a new series coming out as well.
Yeah. I'm gonna wait. So second book just started. Soul Plumber. The art is a little bit on the crazy side, but it delves into a little bit of pseudo religion, a bit of smoke and mirrors, magic, incantation, exorcism. So I think it's 5 or 6 issues only.
What's it about?
There it is. Pause it, you can read it.
Oh, come on. I want to know what it's about.
One sentence.
I don't know. I'm only like 1.5 issues in. So
it's, yeah, but like is Soul Plumber a character?
No, it's a doohickey that this charlatan is selling to gullible religious deviants who want to kind of make the world a better place by guiding the lost to the straight path. And this okay, there you go.
It's a great synopsis.
Yeah.
I had it in me. Anyway. the third book that I am interested in starting once I finish Soul Plumber is something that Steve, you and I might have a short discussion, which is, I think the whole run by Tom Taylor is already up to five or six. And he's, I think he's already ended it. So fingers crossed, all collected in hardcover Omni. So
you guys should review it when you're done.
Yeah, we might have a short discussion. Why not?
We should.
Three books for me. Two and a half. One and a half.
Okay. Nice. Well, with that being...
I just noticed something that's pretty cool. Is when you look at the overall spread, Bo is like the Marvel guy. And I feel like people have pointed this out. Bo's the Marvel guy. Sharif kind of goes both ways, goes all ways. Sharif's a free, easy living character.
Yeah, he does.
Like the DC.
Yeah, he does.
And I'm always bringing all these indies, like I like the Image Comics, and every now and then I'll whip.
We should call you Independent Aaron.
I thought you were going to say Indian Aaron because
I thought you were going to say Indian Mac. No. Indian Mac.
Oh. Indian. Oh no, I'm saying Indian. Shit. Independent Aaron.
That's too many syllables, right? Let's just see how let's just start off with this is a precursor, and then we'll go from, you know, like the motorcycle.
No, not Indian.
Indian Mac.
And it should be Indy. Indy.
Indy Mac.
Indy Mac.
Oh,
Indy
no. Mac. You know. Indiana. Like Jones.
Indiana Mac.
Right?
You're calling it Dr. Mac, lady.
What about Indiana Mac?
I'm short around.
Indiana Mac Sport.
Indiana Mac. Man, we're getting too many. That we're getting too bogged down into the. Well, it's a working name. It's a working name, but indie something or other. Yeah.
Okay.
But that's enough. Cool. I like that. We're gonna get spread.
Well, thank you very much for watching the video. But before we do go, we just want to say that next week, a very special day happens. What is it? What is it? What's the special day that happens next week, ladies and gentlemen?
Metro Comic Con?
My birthday?
That's right, Steve's birthday next week, ladies and gentlemen. Let's join his Woo! He's going to have a birthday next week. He's going to have a birthday next week. The reason why I'm making it a thing now is because who knows the videos after this video that it might be too late because who knows when they go up. But I'm hoping this goes up tomorrow, which for you at home who's watching this, this is yesterday.
No.
I'm doing my own head in. But, yeah, Steve, mate, how's it feel when you're finally going to be turning 30?
I can't remember.
Oh, okay.
But thank you for the nice words.
Yeah, of course, mate. We hope there's some karaoke in your future very soon. Hint, hint.
And a PS5.
That's it.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Steve did win himself a PS5. How? Well, you're going to have to figure that out for yourself. No, I don't know. What am I going? He won in a raffle, all right? He spent 30 bucks and he won in a raffle. 30 bucks.
PS5. Unbelievable.
Amazing.
Okay, well, we're just going to let... Oh, man, I wasn't quick enough. I was going to say, Steve, take us out with that dance.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. See you later, ladies and gentlemen. We'll catch you next time.
Oh.